Namaste. I am Pratibha Kini. Welcome back to my channel. What is agility? Google Dictionary says it is the ability to move quickly and easily. What is mental agility? It is the ability to think and understand quickly. Is agility a quality a dancer must possess? I don't even have to answer that. While practicing or performing a fast-paced varnam or a tillana, you might find that you're not able to stick to the beats. It becomes important that we train our body to move quickly, to train our brain to understand the patterns quickly, to change the movement in the flick of a finger. You could achieve these by obviously practicing the piece over and over again. Also, through agility drills, which can become part of your workout. These help you with neural patterns and fire up your central nervous system. This means they activate your muscles and improve your motor control, or in simple words, your movement. I have designed today's follow-along routine such that we cover all these aspects. Since the intensity of these exercises are going to be high, due to the fast pace of movements, we need to warm up well before we start the routine. I hope you checked my videos on warm-up. If not, please go check them out and warm up well before you dive into the routine. Do subscribe to my channel for some useful videos. Like always, I will be sharing a useful tip, so do watch till the very end. We will be doing 10 exercises for 30 seconds each, with few seconds break in between each exercise. That's when I will explain the next exercise. You can catch your breath and sip water if necessary during that time. First exercise is feet in and out. Let's begin. Start with your feet shoulder width apart, with knees slightly bent. Step in one leg after the other and similarly step out. Let's begin. Try to maintain the pace from the beginning till the end. Do not go too fast if you cannot sustain the speed. Next exercise in 3, 2, 1. Start in a Naramundi. Outstretch your right leg to Anchitapada and switch legs quickly. Let's begin. This helps with quick lateral movement in Adavus such as Natadavu. Hold your core tight and do not swing your hips. Next exercise in 3, 2, 1. Begin by hopping on one leg and landing on both with feet shoulder width apart. Keep alternating. Let's begin. This helps to switch quickly between single leg and double leg balance in Adavus like Pakkadavu or Kattadavu. Next exercise in 3, 2, 1. Alternate running fast and slow in the same place. Count 10 steps and switch speed. Let's begin. Stay on the balls of your feet and keep feet low to the ground, moving as fast as possible, and slow down for a bit after a while. Alternate between fast and slow pace. The objective is to learn to change the speed of the feet between Adavus. Next exercise in 3, 2, 1. Jump to the right, crossing left foot back. Jump to the left, Simultaneously, turn back, crossing right foot back. Alternate between right and left, front and back. Let's begin. This not only tests quickness, but also helps to improve coordination due to the changing patterns. Make sure to place the big toe of one foot right behind small toe of other foot, like you do in Swastika Sthanaka. Next exercise in 3, 2, 1. Stand with your feet hip-width apart or together. Jump with both the feet to the right and left. Let's begin. Keep your knees soft and maintain your back straight. Keep a steady pace. Next exercise in 3, 2, 1. Jump on the balls of the feet in Nagabandha Sthanaka. Quickly change to Anchitapada. Switch and repeat. Let's begin. Make sure to alternate between right and left when you come to Nagabandha position. Whichever foot is behind in Nagabandha Sthanaka will be stretched outwards to Anchitapada. Next exercise in 3, 2, 1. Start in Aramandi, turn back from right and come to Amulumandi, stretching your left leg as you get up, like we do in Tattaita Madavu. Keep alternating. Let's begin. Here we are switching legs swiftly, turning back and forth, sitting and getting up, putting our coordination, agility, and balance to test. Next exercise in 3, 2, 1. Start in Aramandi. Keep the right leg in Anchitapada and switch to lunge on the left leg. Add a jump as you switch. Keep alternating. Let's begin. We use these movements in Natadavu. Switching between Anchitapada and Kunchitapada helps in balancing the body when we have to manage the body weight entirely on one leg. Next exercise in 3, 2, 1. Place a skipping rope to form a circle. Sit in Mulumandi inside the circle and jump outside the circle as you transition to Ekapada Sthanaka. Keep alternating. Let's begin. The skipping rope makes sure you move laterally. You could also use a scarf or a towel to draw boundaries for your jump. This helps in Mandiyadavu and in choreographies where you constantly sit and get up and balance while moving. I suggest that you repeat this routine twice or thrice to reap benefits. Do not forget to cool down after your routine. Check this video I made for cool down if you haven't already. So what factors determine agility? First, to be agile while dancing requires core strength, ability to change focus quickly, balance, flexibility, range of motion, and knowing your next move. I've made videos for most of them and will be adding the links in the description box below. Do check them out. The exercises which we just did help to improve 1. Reactability and movement coordination. The movement is changing so quickly that your brain is getting trained to respond faster and instruct you to coordinate. 2. Balance. In the middle of dynamic movement, we are practicing quick stops and starts, limbic coordination, speed work, which help the body parts to work in sync. Thus, movements become more fluid, smooth, and transitions become well coordinated. 3. Muscular endurance. The ability of a muscle or group of muscles to sustain repeated movements, which leads to 4. Force. The ability to change from rest to motion and vice versa, which leads to 5. Strength. To exert force using your muscles. That's how you move quickly, which leads to 6. Speed. These exercises increase speed of feet for dancers, and you can dance with ease in Drutakalam. So we have found the solution to the problem statement we stated in the introduction. So please adapt these exercises in your training regime. Coming to the tip, a dancer's movements are not only about complicated steps. It is also important to have control of the steps and the body. Today, while performing these fast-paced movements, you might have discovered how good or bad your body control is. Body control is an element every dancer should master. Once you attain control of your own body, you can add difficult patterns and moves and broaden your choreographic choices. With body control, your footwork looks stronger. You might pick up the steps really fast. That means your mental agility is good. But when it comes to performing the same step, you might be shaky and wobbly. This is due to lack of body control and agility. So what you can do is try coordinating your eyesight, breath, and the movement. For example, when you do Tattai Tamadavu, if you look straight ahead and try to turn back and sit down, chances are you will lose balance because your eyes are looking somewhere and you are doing something else. It is difficult for your brain to coordinate. Whereas looking at your hand as you turn and stretch your leg on the same side, the movements are much more coordinated. We all know this. Yato hastas tato drishti, yato drishti tato manaha. Ages ago, Nandikeshwara, in his Abhinaya Darpana, already gave us all the tips. It is up to us to adapt and put it into practice. So let your gaze always follow your hand. Your body and mind will be left with no choice but to follow. I will end this video on that note. Make sure to leave me a comment as to which is your favorite move and how you liked today's routine. Your feedback means a lot to me. Give me a thumbs up and click that like button if you think this was helpful, and share it with your friends. Be sure to subscribe to my channel because I post some super useful content every Saturday at 7 p.m. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you next week.